is the problem. You have a problem. Blessing is lacking. So Jabez noticed these characteristics in his life. Then one day he looked at his life. He said, I am intelligent. I am smart. I am talented.
Yes.
But why is my life not going forward? And a revelation came to him that he lacked the blessings of God. So he stood before the Lord. He said, oh Lord, that thou would bless me and enlarge my goals. I see you enlarging in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I say, I see you enlarging in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I see you enlarging from the right,
amen,
to the left,
amen,
to the front,
amen,
to the back.
Amen.
I see you enlarging.
Amen.
I see your business expanding.
Amen.
I see your vision going global.
Amen.
Oh my, this congregation is not with me. You are enlarging your dream.
Amen.
Your dream will not end at the four walls of your room.
Amen.
Your dream will go beyond the four walls of your room.
Amen.
Your dream will be enlarged and will go global, and men will begin to connect to you. Ah, somebody shout glory. Somebody shout
hallelujah.
So, Jabez has to contain. He has to fight a negative prophecy. Negative prophecy. And that's why I told everybody, don't name my child. When I gave birth to my first child, my elder sister was saying, okay, we have to name it after our mother. Yes, I love my mom, but I don't know the meaning of her name, so I'm not taking that name. I gave the name of my child Fruitfulness. It's prophecy for her life. Praise God. So when we gave birth to the second child, we already have the name Miracle. It's prophecy. Because if I come there and say, hey, receive miracle today. Oh, you will go, ask, go home. Miracle will follow you. Say amen. Why can't I say that into the life of my child? So I want you to understand that name is the first prophecy that a child carries. Name is the first prophecy that a child carries. And so now we're having, you know, my wife was telling me that, okay, the first baby we name, you know, after my own dialect, so the second baby has to be after her own dialect. I said, okay, but we have to understand the meaning of that name. Praise God. So they gave one. When I asked the meaning, okay, but I didn't like that, though it had good meaning. Then I said, ask your mother, what is the meaning of good news in your dialect? Yeah, we'll use your dialect, but what is the meaning of good news? They said it to us, and that's what we are using.
Amen.
My God, hallelujah.
Amen.
So, our name is Miracle Good News. Whether you like it or not, that's the prophecy.
Amen.
That's what I want her to carry.
Amen.
Amen. So if you want to name my child after your dialect, I will give you the English name, which is blessing, then translate to your dialect and give it back to me. I will accept it.
Amen.
Because we have to check carefully who is speaking into your life. Who is your pastor? Do you know your pastor? Do you know your pastor? Be careful. Do you know him? Because when you have a pastor, the first thing you need to do is to find out about him. Try to know him. I'm telling you the truth. No pastor, most pastors will not tell you this. Praise God. Because the first thing we are doing is an impartation. So if my life is crooked life, and I'm speaking into your life,
this place cannot pass this place now.
Jesus said it. He said, you know, a servant cannot be greater than the master. So it's the spirit of your master. Now let me tell you something. When the work became too heavy for Moses, what did the Lord did? He said, select 70 men, take your spirit and put in them so that they can act, they can help you out with the work. Are you understanding me? So the kind of spirit your pastor have, the kind of spirit you have. Believe it, like it or not, the kind of spirit the person who is pastoring you have is the kind of spirit you will have.
Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
So we have to be careful. Amen. unto Jabez, enlarge my cause, and that thou might be with me. The Bible says that God was with Joseph. The presence of God. That's why Moses cried. He said, if your presence does not go, I'm not going. Because there is something about the presence of God. And I think that was our meditation also. You can't do anything without God. Without God first. Without the presence of God. So Jabez noticed that his life was in catastrophe because he lacked these few things in his life. Number one, he was not blessed. Number two, he was suffering from limitation. Number three, he did not have God. He did not have God in his life. Number four, he said, thou will keep me from evil, that it may not grieve me. So number four, all evil things, all bad things were happening to him. All evil things. In fact, name all the evil things in the world. That's what Jabez was experiencing. So he did not have the blessings of God. He was suffering from limitation. He did not have the presence of God. And all evil were befalling him. Hallelujah. And sometimes you ask yourself, is it only me? And all the things that happens to you, no good things ever happen to you. No good things. Evil things. That keep me from evil. Praise God. That's why Samuel says in Psalm 91 that thou will deliver me from all evil. Deliver me from, because when evil is determined against you, evil can frustrate your life. Evil can really, really frustrate your life. Evil can frustrate your life. Four things Jabez cried for. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Blessings of God. And that is what I speak into your life today in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You shall be blessed when you go out.
Amen.
You shall be blessed when you come in.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus,
amen.
I prophesy into your life. As you leave this place, you are going to be a blessing carrier.
Amen.
The Bible says that God told Abraham that you leave your father's house and go to a land that I will show you, and I will make you great, and I will bless you, that you will be a blessing. So a dimension of blessing is descending upon your life this morning that will make you to be a blessing.
Yes.
Can somebody shout hallelujah?
Hallelujah.
Number two, enlargement. By the anointing of God upon my life, I break every spirit of limitation upon your life.
Amen.
I break every stagnation.
Amen.
Every spirit of cycle.
Amen.
Every spirit of mediocrity.
Amen.
I break it out of your life in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And I command expansion.
Amen.
I say I command expansion.
Amen.
I enlarge your course.
Amen.
I increase your boundary.
Amen.
I increase your territory.
Amen.
Oh, this congregation is not understanding me.
Amen.
I say I enlarge your course.
Amen.
I increase your boundary.
Amen.
From the north to the south. From the east to the west.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I increase the dimension of your boundary.
Amen.
I expand your territory.
Amen.
I expand your territory.
Amen.
I expand your territory.
Amen.
By this anointing.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ. Enlargement. Enlargement. Can somebody stand up and say, Lord, enlarge me. Open your hand and say, Lord, enlarge me. Oh my God, you didn't get it. Say, enlarge me. Say, enlarge me, Lord. Say, enlarge me. Rebo Sakata. Say, Lord, increase my territory. Say, Lord, increase my territory. Enlarge me. Increase my territory. Enlarge me, Lord. Increase
my boundary. I increase your boundary. I increase your territory. I keep up limitation and I command your boundary to be increased in the name of Jesus. Oh, thank you, Father.
Listen to me. You know, sometimes even in back in our villages, you will find boundaries. Somebody will even build a fence. And then maybe your space is small and you are managing your space. There are some people, even in their compound, they don't have space to plant toilet there because somebody has built boundary and said, this is my own boundary, so you cannot cross. Listen to me, I come here, I don't know the boundary the enemy has placed, and said, your bank account will never exceed 1,000. There are some people, the enemy has put a boundary that their bank account will not exceed 500 euros. There are some people, they can't even have 100 euros, but any financial boundary, I remove it. Oh yeah, I remove it. I increase your boundary from zero to optimum. I say from zero to optimum. I increase your boundary. Can somebody shout hallelujah? My God, the Lord has said somebody's boundary is being enlarged now. Somebody's boundary is being increased now. Oh, my Shakatala. As you live here today, you say bye-bye to limitation, bye-bye to stagnation. I don't know what has been holding you, but I have come to move you. I have come to tell you, it's time to go forward. I have come to tell you, it's time to increase. And you are breaking forth. I see you are breaking forth. You are crossing the line. You are breaking the limit. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Sit down for 1 minute after you run up. So we close. So Jabez prayed to increase his boundary. Next one. Bless my God. And he said, keep me away from evil. No evil will see you from today.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Every evil eyes that has been spotted on you, by the anointing upon my life, I speak blindness upon their life now.
Amen.
The eyes of your enemy will be blind from today.
Amen.
Those demons, those evil powers that have been monitoring your growth, monitoring your progress in life, I command them to be blind right now.
Amen.
I smash them with blindness.
Amen.
From today, they will no longer see you.
Amen.
From today, they will no longer see your family.
Amen.
From today, they will no longer see your finance.
Amen.
From today, they will no longer be able to monitor you.
Amen.
Because they are blind in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Thank you, Father. So names are prophecy. And in our prophecy, once it's a positive prophecy, know that it attracts also enemies. Our prophecy attracts enemies. So your warfare is determined by the size of your prophetic mandate. I've made that clear. Let's go back to 1 Timothy. Chapter 1, verse 18, that's where we were. Yeah, it says, this charge I commit unto thee, son Timothy, according to the prophecy which went before you. We went before on thee, that thou by them mightest war a good warfare. So, if you understand your prophecy, you will know how to fight. The reason some people don't even pray, some people cannot pass, is because they don't understand their prophecy. He said, it is by your prophecy that you walk. So the understanding of your prophecy
gives you momentum to fight. So when you don't understand your prophecy, like Samson didn't understand his prophecy. So when you don't understand your prophecy, you will misappropriate that prophecy. So there are people that misappropriate prophecy, like Samson. The angels of the Lord appear to their parent and said, you're going to be pregnant and you're going to give birth to a deliverer who is going to save the Israelite from the Midianite. But this man misappropriated his prophetic mandate on the lap of a woman. So there are some things, activities we indulge into because we lack a simple understanding of our prophetic mandate, what we are carrying. When you understand your prophecy, then you won't talk anyhow. When you understand your prophecy, you will not just follow any kind of company. When you understand your prophecy, you will not just be living your life anyhow without putting God, without prayers, without seeking God. When you understand your prophecy, praise God. So Paul was telling Timothy, because Timothy was a young pastor, and God, Paul was exhorting him and telling him that remember the prophecy that has been spoken into your life, so that by those prophecy you will war a mighty warfare. So if God has told you this 2017, like he has said that it's our year of building, you have to use that prophecy to begin to combat the devil. Let it be an arrow. Let it be a bullet for you to use against your enemy. That when you get up in your house, you don't just get up and then you just jump from your bed and go out, and sometimes you don't even know where you're going and you just meet people at Oyo Square. They say, hey brother, how are you, man? You don't even know where you are going. Praise the Lord. When you get up in the morning, you say, Lord, you have said this year is a year of building. Our devil, yeah.